It's time for Mr.
Fundamental.
Presented by no one.
The Kings came into this game with all the momentum and seeking revenge ever since their blowout loss in the season opener against the Suns. On the other hand, the Suns were on the second night of a back-to-back, and it really showed in the first quarter. To start the game, a sloppy pass by Rubio leads to a steal and transition layup by Hield. The Kings' offense is still very stagnant, but a quick crossover by Hield gets him into the paint. Rubio digs down on Holmes, since Saric had to step up. The gather of the ball makes Rubio take a step to his man, and a bounce pass gets them to score. After the double screen for Bogdanović, the offense stops. The only movement was Hield setting a back screen that was even used. They only ran a second pick and roll, with 5 seconds left on the clock. Unfortunately, Bjelica bailed them out. The Kings were just hitting shots all around. A handoff into pick and roll forces defensive miscommunication. Both Oubre and Saric stayed on Bogdanović. A swing and a quick release by Hield gets them a 3, but Holmes was wide open on the roll and would have gotten the rebound if Hield misses. Defensively, they sagged off Rubio like all teams do, and a late closeout leads to a miss. Besides that, they didn't do anything special to stop the Suns' offense. This is the first time I've seen a defender guard the opponent's best player like that, giving them a free lane to the rim. Booker cuts when Rubio receives the pass, and his off-arm forces Hield to trail, but Hield strips it before the damage was done. Offensively, the Suns were getting their usual looks. This double pin down was a diversion for a Booker back screen. Kaminsky draws the foul and barely misses the layup. There was basically a lid on top of the rim the whole night. Johnson attacks the closeout, and this was a good step up by Dedmon. Johnson's floater touches every part of the rim before rolling out. This was great positional defense for the Kings, and Bogdanović closes out well. Booker has to create from scratch, and his drive forces the help one pass away. This was a good corner look by Oubre, but it misses. The Suns just weren't in the game. Booker sets a back screen for Oubre, and Kaminsky almost throws it away when Booker wasn't aware. This worked out in their favor when both Hield and Barnes leave Booker wide open for the jumper, but again, it misses. Including those missed shots with these turnovers, the Kings led by 14 after the first. The second quarter was more of the same. The Kings extended their lead by attacking early in transition. Here, Barnes had the mismatch. Bogdanović throws a perfect lob pass, leading to a dunk. Speaking of Bogdanović, he was a big part of this lead. Their offense was struggling to find openings in the half court, but he hit some tough shots to bail them out. He gets the steal on Booker, and in transition, they don't score instantly. Bogdanović doesn't stop moving behind a scrambling defense, and makes a 3-ball, with a little help from Hield. The Kings also ran some plays that were very similar to the Suns. Holmes back screen for Barnes after the handoff. Another lob pass gets them a shot at the rim. The Suns continue to miss shots, like this good look from deep. But what I did find interesting is how they defended this inbound. Ferro uses the Barnes screen to cut up for the ball. Rubio was guarding the inbounder, and he switches onto Ferro, while Bridges covers the inbounder. This didn't lead to a direct stop, but that was an interesting concept. The third quarter was when the Suns started to chip into the lead with their zone defense. They started the quarter with man defense, and it didn't go well. The pick and roll forces a mismatch down low. You can see Johnson looking for the switch to get the bigger Oubre on Holmes. That doesn't happen, forcing Oubre to help. Then skip pass leads to an open 3. When they switched to zone, the Kings had some good ball movement, but this was just better defensive rotations by the Suns. The zone also got the Kings out of their pick and roll sets. Bjelica makes a nice cut towards the elbow, but again, nice rotation by the Suns. Diallo picks up Bjelica, and Johnson digs down to prevent the wraparound pass to Holmes. Booker also started to take matters into his own hands, blowing past Joseph, and there was no rim protector because of the initial switch. If you think there was a huge scoring run for the Suns to come back, you'll be disappointed. The Suns did start hitting some open shots, but the Kings made timely shots to keep their lead. It should have been over when the Kings often stagnates, but Bjelica hits this deep 3. But the Suns kept drawing fouls and got away with this poor defensive possession. The Suns did a good job with their full court press trying to extend the game, but if it wasn't for this late 3 by Kaminsky, the Suns would have lost by more than 4. The Kings are starting to rack up some wins, even with the injuries to Fox and Bagley. The Kings' defense has improved, since they're limiting opponents to shoot around 30% from deep in the past few games. Their offense is still stagnant, which isn't surprising with Luke Walton at the helm. But for the same reason, they should be getting out in transition, instead of having a pace that ranks second last in the league. The Suns really missed Aron Baynes as their enforcer who carves up space down low. It's no surprise they shot 30% at the half. I'll be making a video on Baynes' impact outside of his box score numbers, so stay tuned. Thank you for watching this video and I hope you enjoyed it. The Twitter poll should be up for tonight's games, so go and vote for the game you want me to break down. Please give this a like rating down below, subscribe, and I'll see you next time.